First, though, I'm just going to go on this real quick. Getting shot, it's like getting hit by this, somebody hitting you with a sledgehammer. Imagine somebody's hitting you with a sledgehammer, bro. Just a matter of being kicked by a horse. It's hard shit. It's not just, man, like, so anybody that's gets shot, that's been shot, sometimes you might just catch a flesh wound, but, bro, when you really get hit solid, bro, it's like some unimaginable type shit, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, Philando Jenkins got hit like 4 times at point blank range. It broke his arm. If you can see in that video, did you notice how his arm was like bent up?
Yeah.
That shit broke his fucking arm, bro. Like, he was in so much pain. He probably wanted to cry, scream for help, and all that shit, dog. But you don't even have that kind of energy okay. when you get hit like
so,
that.
So describe what was Philando Jenkins for the people that don't know. What happened?
Shit, he was driving with his girlfriend, got pulled over by like a Lauderdale cop or like one of them St. Paul suburbs, like right outside, you know, got pulled over by like one of them funny ass suburb cops. Kind of like the one that pulled me over in Crystal. Officer Venezuela. You know what I'm saying? Dick sucking Venezuela. You know what I'm saying?
So, pulled me over. So the Jenkins happened not far from you? Or was it a different part of the state?
No, it wasn't far from me. No, it wasn't far from me. It was about 20 minutes from where I where I was at. All right, so Minneapolis, St. Paul are right next to each other. You cross a river.
Okay.
All right, so this was like a St. Paul incident. So St. Paul, bro, don't go to St. Paul, man. They got they put something in the wire to make motherfuckers slower or something. I swear, bro, it's like this unwritten rule that if you're from Minneapolis, you don't fuck with St. Paul niggas. And if you're from St. Paul, you don't dare come across and fuck with no Minneapolis niggas. And when it does happen, somebody gets robbed every motherfucking time, damn near. Oh, some St. Paul niggas, let's rob them. Oh, some Minneapolis niggas, St. Paul niggas, oh, let's rob. Like, so I've lost homies to this stupid ass little thing that goes on. You know what I'm saying? So there's like this little beef between Minneapolis, St. Paul, where we just don't fuck with each other. But I'm going to be real with you. I've lived in both cities. I'm going to say there's something wrong with St. Paul. All right. I'm just going to say it. I've lived everywhere. I'm going to say it's St. Paul. Sorry, fellas. But so anyway, and St. Paul's like, I guess, like one of them old mob towns where like John Dillinger and fucking Al Capone and them used to come and like hang out and like blow their money and have the police paid off. St. Paul's always been a corrupt city.
Ain't there a rapper from St. Paul? Like Juicy J or one of them type of rappers?
Nah, nobody from Minneapolis ever made it too good.
Damn. Okay.
Maybe like R&B motherfuckers. Like Prince and shit like that. You seen what they did with Prince. We ain't gonna get into that. We seen what they did with Prince, bro. So, you know what I'm saying? Back to motherfucking Philando Jenkins. So the cop walks up on him about whatever, I don't know. And they have a conversation like bitch ass cops, you know, they press up on you and they have a certain thing in their mind what they're gonna do to you, no matter what you're doing. So he's like, you know what? Yeah, I got a gun on me. I got a permit. Now you gotta watch the dash cam and get the body cam. Everybody can request that. I mean, I guess I could if I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But I know my homie knows his cousin. So I might be able to get his cousin on here to talk about it. That's a big thing. So I might be able to show your motherfuckers know I'm not just out here just blowing smoke. I really know people like that, so I really might be able to get his cousin to come on here, you know what I'm saying, and talk about his loss. I don't know why he wouldn't.
That too. I feel like people need to talk about him too.
They do, and I can almost guarantee you within a week, I'll try and get him on here. You know what I'm saying? Never met him. My homie who lives like a block away from me right now, he knows him. He fucks with him. He's been over there recently a few times in the last month or two over there, you know, chopping it up with him. I don't fuck with St. Paul. I'm like, yo, why you go to St. Paul, man? That's like, for what? You know, so I fuck with him about that. But he goes over there and still fuck with Buddy. You know, so I know he feels like a certain way about it. And he has like a certain theory about it. Whether he wants to come out here and talk about it, I don't know. So the cop shoots him 4 times, while he reached after letting him reach for his permit.
Damn.
Yeah, get your permit. Bow, 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 bow.
That's a cold way to go.
I don't know how that girl pulled that phone out with all that shit happening. But somehow she had this footage.
That was like the beginning of Facebook Live.
I didn't really realize that. I didn't know because you got to remember, I'm not a big social media guy.
Yeah, that was like the first thing. Well,
you far might as be right. But now that you're bringing that up, yeah, you are kind of right about that, I think.
Because she went
viral. I'm from here, so I'm from here and I've seen it, so I didn't really know that it was like worldwide like that. You know? But you still there? Yo, what's up, bro?